All right, welcome everyone to a special Rogues Gallery. Doing a little bit of live brewing here. Basically, just got done writing an article with this brew in mind, and we're going to start off exactly where the article left off. If anybody has not read it, I believe it's called A Good Day to Brew. Sometime early March, it went up. The basic combo that we're going to be just trying to use here. And this could very easily end up being just a poopy deck, but I wanted to try it out. I haven't seen anybody play it, so I wanted to see if it was any good. Basically, you're looking to abuse Veilborn Ghoul and Sphinx of the Chimes to draw a bunch of cards. You also have Liliana of the Veil plus Veilborn Ghoul as a little bit of a synergy. You have the end game of Borghimos. We'll see if that works out or not. Also, Keswick Wolf Run is another option to win with. Hey, look at that. I get an upgrade discount. Are you guys excited for me? Other than that, it's pretty much just like kind of a dirtily control deck. You could beat control decks by attacking with Veilborn Ghouls and whatnot. Grimoire of the Dead as well is kind of your second, but Borghimos. I'm skeptical to see if the deck kind of gets through its combo stuff flawlessly, but we're gonna find out. We're gonna get some games in with this, and one way or another, we're gonna see if the deck's any viable. We're gonna be messing around with things. We have a bunch of options like Lot Lachol can make the main deck, Planeswalkers can make the main deck. We can swap around removal. We could add different win conditions. There's a lot of things that could change about it, but like I said, basically just simple control deck, Duress, one Faithless Looting, so you can pitch up a Borghimos if you draw them, Farseekes, Mulches, Abrupt Decays, Grisly Salvage. A bunch of Lilianas, three Mutilates, one Grimoire of the Dead. I don't know why this keeps going down. One Grimoire of the Dead, two Unburial Rites to get these guys into play, four Veilborn Ghoul, three Sphinx, one Borghimos, some lands, a bunch of swamps over here. We have three Water Graves, two Blood Crypt, two Godless Shrine, four Overgrown Tomb, in addition to the four swamps here. So a lot of swamps to trigger these guys. And then four Woodland Cemetery and a Breeding Pool round out our lands over here. Sideboard's just kind of a bunch of possibilities. Nothing that is 100% should be there. It's kind of let me swap things in and out, like two Lot Lachols, two Gloom Surgeons. One of these is definitely better than the other, but I don't know what it is. A couple Garruk Relentless, trying that card out. We have an additional Unburial Rites in case that ends up being more important than Grimoire of the Dead. A little bit of extra removal against aggro, a little bit of extra hand disruption against control. So yeah, pretty straightforward. This deck could very easily just bumble and fumble and fail all over itself, but we're gonna go find out if it does that right now. So I'll be right back, and we'll jump into two man. All right, we have returned. Don't have a great hand here, but it's fine. We're on the draw. We have Farseek, some early removal, and Sphinx. I don't know how often we get to draw cards off Sphinx when it's not Veilborn Ghouls, but we'll see. So of note here, as I think I'm gonna hold off on the Watery Grave. Maybe it's fine. I guess I'm gonna Farseek for a swamp. So I kind of want to like put this into play tapped on turn one. The only blue cards in my deck are this anyway. Yeah, I think that's correct. We're gonna see what he does first. All right, he's back. He's played a Watery Grave. What are we drawing? Ooh. Yeah, that's worth it. I want to see what he's up to, and my next couple turns are likely going to be planned out with Farseek on turn two, and then anything we draw on turn three, since we'll have up to four mana. So I just want to kind of get an idea with what we're working with here. So he's just straight Esper. He's going to play an Augur Bolas next turn. We're going to take Sphinx's Revelation, pretty obviously, because taking things twice would be bad. But that was fine. So we know he has two Drown Yards, Snapcaster Mage, Think Twice, and Augur Bolas. I think our deck's decent against control. Veilborn Ghoul is a legitimate threat against them, assuming you don't walk too many of them into a Detention Sphere. You pretty much want to trade one for one. But that's one reason we have the Keswick Wolf Run in the deck, so you can play any one Veilborn Ghoul. It's just a huge threat. Like I said, it's kind of like Borghimos. Just a different way to win with your Veilborn Ghouls. He just doesn't do anything. So, I'm just going to Farseek. We'll Grisly Salvage next turn. What are we going to get? We want a white or a red. We only have the one Faithless Looting. We have two Unburial Rites, and we're going to Grisly Salvage next turn. So, I guess I get the white. Actually, red has Keswick Wolfrun though, which we do have. All right, I'll do that. A sweet set of lands, simply. Technically, our five colors, but not really. All right, he drew his Hollowed Fountain, put it in play tapped. He didn't even cast Think Twice, which is weird to me. I'm gonna cast this now because if I hit a mulch, or wait, I can't hit a mulch. What can I hit off this? A land, I guess. Sure, you can think twice in response. So I hit a Watergave and I bin a bunch of stuff, including a Faithless Looting, a Mutilate, and a Liliana. Sure. Faithless Looting is not bad. Enjoying Watergate is decent because I have two Sphinxes in my hand. I would have liked it some Veilborn Ghouls, but what are you going to do? Mutilate is not the best. Put this in a play tapped. I could just Faithless Looting here. Discard Mutilate and something else. Yeah, it's not a bad idea. I assume he's just going to be fine with this, and he's just going to flash that back. I could have kept the Watergrave, but I know I want to play it this turn because I have the two Sphinxes in hand, so it doesn't matter. It's technically correct to hold it in my hand in case someone discarded to Faithless Looting, but I cannot think of a scenario where that is not the land I would play this turn, so. He's really in the tank here. Alright. So, definitely pitching this and this. We drew Liliana, which is one of our pretty good cards against control. We'll see if he taps out or anything. We're going to play Sphinx this turn. He's almost assuredly just going to kill it right away. Right, I'm going to save the swamp. Make him use some removal on this, or counterspell, or whatever. No, nothing. Alright, well, we have this guy in play, so. He's gonna mill. Tribute to Hunger, sure. Three Drown Yards, you say? Another Grizzly Salvage. Let's do this before we Liliana. So if I hit any, Ooh, I did hit two Veilborn Ghouls. All right, that's pretty sweet. So we're gonna pick this guy up, put these in the graveyard. We're gonna play this. I guess I can't play around any. What's he got? Oh, he does have syncope. Okay, but I can't play around that. All right, play this. Pick up these guys. Maybe he'll mill us some more. So now we have Abrupt Decay open, and we have this engine online. So if we resolve a Sphinx, we're getting draw cards. It's kind of sweet. Okay, finally plays that. He does have Snapcaster Mage, but not only has access to four mana, and he knows I have a Sphinx. Alright, let's discard these two guys. We drew a Godless Shrine, so I get to return them. And potentially mulch or do something like that this turn. So let's take two. Yeah, obviously I want to use the ability. Thank you, Bobby. Alright, so we do have to worry about Drown Yard here. So I don't want to mulch, I don't think. I think I just pass and discard mulch, actually. Could discard one of these ghouls, but I guess one odd man ghoul out is not the best. So if I pitch a ghoul, I guess I'm likely to draw the other ghoul. I'm just not going to cast this mulch, so it's completely pointless. Not going to mill myself four. Now the thing is, we still do have to win. He's casting Supreme Virgin. Alright, we're gonna discard two of these guys, draw four cards. I could discard these two Abrupt Decays. Go to 21 cards. Resolve Liliana. Then he's going to race me to milling. Yeah, I'll do it. And that's it for me. Okay. Could cast this. It's five cards. I don't want to do that, I don't think. I could have a Borgimos, which does a ton of damage. But I can't cast him. I don't have the other red. The other red's in my yard, isn't it? No. Sorry, I'm kind of fumbling my way through this just like you guys. Alright, I'm just going to draw. Alright, so let's play a swamp. Return a bunch of things. Play this. Plus one inch. I guess I could have done that first, but I wanted to get a land into play. Yeah, I should have done this first. It's fine. I got plenty of swamps. I'm not even going to cast the Sphinx. He doesn't really do anything. I'm just going to cast a Veilborn Ghoul. Actually, the Sphinx is just a bigger threat, I guess. He discarded a Tragic Slip, then I just cast this guy. Then we go to our end step. We discard a lot of cards. Woodland Cemetery, goodbye. Forest, goodbye. Grizzly Savage, goodbye. Kept three swamps. This is the only thing that's worrying me, is he could just go on a mill plan. He only can mill three a turn, so I can just race it, and hopefully just has to keep tapping mana to keep up with me. I'm just going to start littering him with Veilborn Ghouls and attacking, I think. Yeah, it's plus one this. Play this. Let's attack. So if you just play Supreme Verdict, what does that do? It's pretty bad for us. I guess I want to keep lands for Borgimos so I can get him more damage. Maybe I should have just Keswick Wolf Run there. These guys cost so much mana. Kind of want to just unburial rights here. We're going to unburial rights. A Sphinx. And then that keeps two Veilborn Ghouls in my hand in case he doesn't mill me. Oh, he's just casting Sphinx's Revelation? Sure. I'm okay with that. Yeah, I need to start keeping lands for Borgimos. I forgot about that. I probably should have discarded this Farseek. First time playing the deck. Definitely going to make mistakes like that. Just not recognizing what's important. Liliana and Duress are pretty sweet, though. That's his revealed cards. His exile cards. What are my exile cards? Oh, yeah, Faithless Looting. What did Liliana get? Planar Cleansing. Alright. So we're going to discard these guys. Ooh, Grimoire of the Dead. Alright, so I want to play, but oh, I can't cast him. I need the other stupid thing. So, in that case, I'm going to cast this to go get Blood Crypt returning to Veilborn Ghouls. gonna play this. We're gonna play that. We're gonna play this guy. So I have one creature in play, so he feels like compelled to deal with that. Then I have Grimoire of the Dead on Veilborn Ghoul as well. Again, I do have to worry about his mill plan here. Oh, he's got a syncopate. Okay. Should have done that first. Didn't think about it. Fair enough. Rushing through things here. Oh, that's fine. I could just discard that. He should really just be milling me. Okay, now he is. Alright, well. Oh, I have to pay one? Oh, I did not know that. That was bad. Well, I'm dead, so I guess I cast this. Put all these lands in my hand. Play this guy and have 18 damage for him. I guess I could draw. If he doesn't mill me right away, I could draw a land. I could also, need a way to get even two more lands is only 24 damage, so he'd have to take a little damage somewhere. Alright, I'm just going to concede Nacho and Boborgamos. I think I could have won that. I made some stupid mistakes. Alright, so we're going to take out bad cards. Rough Decay deals with Detention Sphere, which I'm worried about a little bit. Okay, we're definitely bringing another Duress. We definitely bring in Garrick. Two of them. Borgamos is fine. I guess we could go to one Rough Decay. Or let's cut one on Burial Rites. No, that card's pretty strong in this matchup. I could cut the Looting. Still Liliana to discard it too, and this card's not great in the match. I guess it's fine. Well, I'm just gonna cut it. Add this. Don't want Slaughter Games. I guess if you want Slaughter Games, this is the matchup you want them in. Alright, two Slaughter Games in, one on Burial Rites, and one Abrupt Decay? Mulch. One Mulch out. Alright, we're gonna try that. No idea if this is good or not, but I guess I could cut one to Abrupt Decay. That would not be ridiculous. For what? Mulch back in? Hitting land drops is pretty good. No, we'll just try it like this.